I'm Joshua Hanlon, and I'm here at BrickCon Seattle with the Great Ball Contraption, and I'll be talking to several of the builders who have some Great Ball Contraption modules on display here. So we'll start with John, if you want to take us through some of what you have on display.
Okay, so I have about 10 modules here. This one I call Circular Logic. This is the newest one I built just for this. Took me about 6 months to get it right. The tricky part about this is that the two tube runs have to be supported completely from the inside and the outside one from the outside. Otherwise it jams, and it took quite a while to get that working, particularly with these, you only have small posts at the top and bottom to connect them. So this is one of my older ones. This is similar to the Akiyuki marble run. One of the differences I've done is I actually have two separate runs that flip back and forth. So when it loads up with balls, and we have a shortage of balls at the moment, it really looks pretty cool. So one on the end, this is I call Escapade, and it's a serpentine lift module. So it just pulls them up in an S shape. And this one actually was difficult to get geared right. Then we fall into a fairly standard ball pump here. And then this is one of the modules from Brick Fair, I think in Chicago. That's a great regulator module, which helps set up for the ski lift module. It doesn't like to get a lot of balls all at once, so the regulation of that helps. Moving on to there is my zigzag stair. This is actually the first module I ever built, and I probably get the most compliments on that one. The kind of optical illusion that you get from the way the balls move up is pretty enchanting. So
right, the different colors and the going up and down and all that's a cool module.
Yeah, and it's not, at first look, it's not real obvious how the balls are actually moving up. And you don't get the zigzag pattern unless really you watch a orange ball like's going up there now. You can really see it, what it does. Then the next one's a two-arm lift module. It's fairly simplistic, but it's also one of my crankier ones. I keep modifying it because it has a tendency to drop balls out a little more than I like. So. So that one's always a work in progress. And then the next one is the sweep stair. This basically came about because I had a whole lot of inverted arches and I couldn't quite figure out what to do with them. And I came up with this idea one day. I said that, you know, it'd make a great stair. And then the last one is a series of rotating wheels that I call the three-wheeler for obvious reasons. And it's a very simple, reliable module, and you can get a lot of height out of it, which is always nice. And then it feeds into this new ramp I built for it, this spiral ramp that makes use of the click hinges. If you put 16 of them in a circle, you get a nice round circle, and if you then offset them a little bit, you get a lovely spiral. It also makes a fun noise when it goes down. So,
well, those are really neat. I love the creativity with your modules and everything, and I think it looks really nicely working all together here. So thanks for talking with us about those.
Yeah, thank you.
And now we'll continue moving on down to some more of the Great Ball Contraption builders here. So we've got a couple of builders down here with some great modules. If you would just want to give us your name and then talk about what you've got here.
I'm Kevin Mitchum, and we've got here the work of three different people, four actually. There's the elevator lift on the end right there. That's my Alec Popio. We just got one of the old school Mindstorms bricks controlling, measuring how far up and down the elevator post the thing is gone. So it actually learns where it is and how fast, so it can slow down to either end. And then here we have a jam.
That's a classic GBC module right there. You see that at almost every GBC. See, figure out what the issue is there.
Yeah, there we go. And once that feed backs up, the conveyor belt clabs itself, but now it should be happy again. So yeah, this is the tower I built. So this one's mine. This is the hole where one of my modules was not making it through another. This is about, not I guess about 18 months long. It didn't live that long, so on the side. My wife built this simple conveyor belt, which runs great, which is why she doesn't have to sit here to babysit it. And we've got two relatively simple push arms that I did. What's neat about some of these is they're running out the same power shaft. We have one motor driving two modules right here. And then we have a stalled train coming right by your fingers there. And a lift wheel acting as a train station because it can pick up from so low. At the other end where we had the feed for the train, I don't know if you got that on film already. The train modules are done by a fellow named Justin. They're actually Arduino powered, so they're not pure Lego. I feel a little dirty. But they're brilliant in that the trains will keep track of where each one of them are, so they know to slow down at the two stations, but they also know where the other train is, so they will try not to collide with each other. So when that's all working, it works great, but like everything else ball contraption, all working and working are different things. But for the most part, it has been running pretty well. The trains come right through the stations, they load up, they drop off, and it's cooler looking than a simple ball return, which is what we've been doing in past years, is this high tower just rolls down, and having a train do the return is much better. Then we're further down if we're ready for that.
Yeah.
Well, actually, we'll jump over. This is the module that broke. Sometimes they break. This one broke 5 minutes before the doors opened this morning. It's run great for a full year in the past, so I don't know.
Oh, my. But that's what GBC does to you, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Just because something worked for 20 hours doesn't mean it's going to work for 21. This is a brand new module that came in from one of the convention organizers, Stephen Walker. And it's beautiful. You got to get a shot from the other side when we come around. But it's not quite reliable enough. Apparently his workbench table is a perfectly flat table on a concrete floor, and so he was dead level, but the tables here aren't, and the tolerances on his module were tight enough that we couldn't make it work. So here we have one of the most multi-person modules we've got, or multi-motional loops we've done at Great Ball Contraption here in Seattle in a long time. I think we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 builders on this one loop. Is it 6? I might have lost count. Anyway, we have a first-time GBCer module right here with the simple wave going on. That's working pretty well once we've got it hooked up. Then I got my sideways conveyor belt. The pumping station, once again, from Alex, who did the elevator station before. Another conveyor belt from my wife in red there that's just going along very gently. And then we have my ball pumping station, which has been to several conventions now, still works pretty well. Then in the middle there, underneath that blue ramp, is the central power station that's running two modules, both the pumping station and the very simple green lift behind it, or ahead of it, depending on which way you're looking. Both of those use the same motor, so this is something I picked up when I first started doing ball contraption, so I only owned one Lego motor then.
Right.
But once you start doing ball contraption, you're gonna end up with more than one motor. Downstream of the Olympia station is, we have Rick's first ever great ball contraption, and that's been working great all day. It's got a little bit of balls left in the idling spots, but it's working fine. Then beyond that, we have another first-time ball contraption folk from someone who's been to this is their very first LEGO convention entirely.
Wow, that's awesome.
And then behind that, we have Alex's glittering wheel, which has been out several times and is working reliably as always, giving us the height so we can have a simple loop without having to power up behind where people can't see anything. And then we have a self-contained thing, which may or may not be running right now. Do we need to poke the balls to get it going there? There we go, it's still working. And that is from another Hadrian Finch, who is the son of the woman who did the giant Hogwarts and everything else.
Oh, yeah.
And this is his first time GBC there. He built it before he looked up the standard, so he can't actually play with the rest of us, but he's running pretty reliably down there himself.
Yeah, that's awesome. So this looks like it all came together really nicely here. It's very cool. So how many builders in total did you say you think are involved?
I thought it's either 7 or 8, of which I'm sorry? 8. It is 8. Okay. And so we have Alex and John and myself, who are all veterans and my wife, but she's not sitting around right here. And then we have 2 or 3, all the rest of them are first time. So that's great. We're growing the theme here some more. We still run in multiple loops so that we don't have quite the pressure of having everyone have to work all the time. Because you saw why we came through. I don't know if John managed to work seamlessly during his interview, but we had a couple of jams up while we're going. Although this one, which is actually sort of the motley crew, has been working more reliably than the one that is mostly just me and Alex. So that's I blame the trains. It's new technology.
Right.
We've got great ideas for the trains, but we got to make them work.
Yeah. Well, that's very impressive. Thanks for showing me that to me. Thank you.
You're right. Welcome. Thanks for talking.